Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Today we will study about symmetric functions of the roots of a quadratic equation. Definition: symmetric functions are those functions in which the roots involved are such that the values of the expression involving them remains unaltered when roots are interchanged. For example, if f is a function of alpha beta that is equal to alpha square plus beta square, then if we replace alpha with beta and beta with alpha, then this function will be equal to beta square plus alpha square, and that can be written as alpha square plus beta square, since beta square plus alpha square is same as alpha square plus beta square. So this is the example of a symmetric function. Just simply when you want to check that the given function is a symmetric function, just interchange the values. For example, here this f function f is the function of alpha beta, and when we interchange these values, alpha with beta and beta with alpha, when we replace these values, the function is unaltered. So we can say that this function is a symmetric function. So let's start the exercise 2.4. Question number 1. If alpha and beta are the roots of the equation x square plus px plus q is equal to 0, then evaluate number 1 alpha square plus beta square, number 2 alpha cube beta plus alpha beta cube, number 3 alpha by beta plus beta by alpha, and you can see that all these three are the symmetric functions. So let's start with one. Given equation is x square plus px plus q is equal to 0. So here a is equal to 1 and b is equal to p and c is equal to q. Just you have to compare this equation with the standard equation, standard quadratic equation. So we know that as it is given that alpha beta be the roots of the given equation, then we know that the sum of the roots is equal to minus b by a. So alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Here b is equal to p and a is equal to 1. So sum of the roots alpha plus beta is equal to minus p. Now product of the roots, we know that the product of the root is equal to c by a. Here c is q and a is 1. So product of the root is equal to q. Now we know, just now we have to find the value of alpha square plus beta square. We know that alpha plus beta whole square is equal to alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta. Now we want to find this value, just we have to shift this 2 alpha beta to the left hand side equation. So we can write this as alpha square plus beta square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. So just we have to find the value of alpha square plus beta square. So we know that alpha plus beta is minus p. Just we have to replace value of alpha plus beta with minus p, and product alpha beta is equal to q. So by replacing these values, we have p square minus 2q. So alpha square plus beta square is equal to p square minus 2q. Part 2, alpha cube beta plus alpha beta cube. Here equation is same, x square plus px plus q is equal to 0. So a is 1, b is p and c is q. As it is given that alpha beta be the roots of the given equation, so alpha plus beta is minus b by a, and alpha beta the product of the root is c by a. So again simple, b is minus b is p and a is 1, so sum of the root is equal to minus p, and here c is q and a is 1, so product of the root is q. Now we have to find the value of alpha cube beta plus alpha beta cube. Now from this expression we can take alpha beta as a common, so we left with alpha square plus beta square. So we now we can write this alpha square plus beta square from here. You can see that alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. Now just we have to replacing the values of alpha minus beta. This is minus p, and product of the root alpha beta is equal to q. So this is equal to q times p square minus 2 q. So the third part you have to take as an assignment. Question number 2. If alpha beta are the roots of the equation 4x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0, then find the value of number 1, 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta, number 2, alpha square beta square, and number 3, 1 over alpha square beta plus 1 over alpha beta square, and number 4, alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha. So let's start with first one, 1 over alpha plus 1 over beta. So given that given equation is 4x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So here is 4, b is equal to minus 5, and c is equal to 6. As it is given that alpha beta be the roots of the given equation, so we can write that sum of the root is equal to minus b by a. Here b is equal to minus 5 and a is equal to 4. So sum of the root is 5 by 4. Here product of the root we know that is equal to c by a. Here c is 6 and a is 4. So after simplification, the product of the root is equal to 3 by 2. So now we have to evaluate the value of 1 over alpha plus 1 over beta. If we take LCM there, and then LCM is equal to alpha beta. So this alpha cancel out with this alpha. So we left with beta, and here we left with alpha. So beta plus alpha can be written as alpha plus beta. Just you have to simplify this. You can add one more step. So sum of the root, we know that this is equal to 5 by 4, and the product of the root 3 by 4, 3 by 2. So 5 by 4 and divided by 3 by 2. And this is in division form. When we convert this into multiplication, so this can be written as 2 by 3. So 5 by 4 multiply with 2 by 3. So this 2 1 times 2 and 2 2 times 4. So we left with 5 by 3 2 times 6. So 5 by 6. So value of 1 over alpha plus 1 by beta is equal to 5 by 6. Part 2, we have to evaluate the value of alpha square plus beta square. Again, equation is 4x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0 is 4, b is minus 5, c is equal to 6. As it is given that alpha beta are the roots of the given equation, and we know that the sum of the root is minus b by a, and product of the root is c by a. So replacing the values of ABC, we have sum of the root is equal to 5 by 4 and product of the root is 3 by 2. Now we have to evaluate the value of alpha square plus beta square. So alpha beta, this can be written as alpha beta whole square. So just we know here simple the value of alpha beta, that is 3 by 2. So this will be equal to 3 by 2 whole square. That can be written as 9 by 4. Part 3. We have to evaluate the value of 1 over alpha square beta plus 1 over alpha beta square. Solution, same equation is given. So a is 4, b is minus 5, c is 6. As it is given that alpha beta be the roots of the given equation, so sum of the root we know that is minus b by a, and product of the root is c by a. So here b is minus 5, a is 4. So sum of the root is equal to 5 by 4. For product of the root is c by a, c is 6, a is 4, and 2 3 times 6 and 2 2 times 4. So product of the root is equal to 3 by 2. Now we have to evaluate the value of 1 over alpha square beta plus 1 over alpha beta whole square, alpha beta square. So just first we have to take the LCM. So LCM of this will be equal to alpha square beta square. So here when we simplify, this will be equal to alpha plus beta divided by alpha square plus beta square. So alpha plus beta is 5 by 4 and alpha beta is 3 by 4. So just alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha beta whole square. So alpha plus beta since is equal to 5 by 4 and alpha beta is 3 by 2 whole square. So 5 by 4, 9 by 4, 9 by 4 is in division. When we convert this into multiplication, that will be equal to 5 by 4. So 4 cancel out with this one, we left with 5 by 9. So 1 over alpha square beta plus 1 over alpha beta square is equal to 5 by 9. Question number 3. If alpha beta are the roots of the equation Lx square plus Mx plus n is equal to 0, where the condition is that L is not equal to 0, then find the value of alpha cube beta square plus alpha square beta cube, and second is 1 over alpha square plus 1 over beta square. So let's start part 1. Alpha cube beta square plus alpha square beta cube. Here it is given that the given quadratic equation is Lx square plus Mx plus n is equal to 0. So here is L. So this is L, B is M, and C is N. As alpha beta are the roots of the given equation, so sum of the root is equal to minus B by A. B is M and A is L. So sum of the root is equal to minus M by L, and product of the root is C by A. And here C is N and A is L. So now we have to evaluate the value of alpha cube beta square plus alpha square beta square. So from this expression, we can take alpha square beta square as a common. So we left with alpha plus beta. So alpha square beta can alpha square beta square can be written as alpha beta whole square. So so now we have to replace the value of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So alpha beta is equal to minus alpha beta is n by l whole square, and sum of the root alpha beta is minus m by l. So this is n square by l square and minus m by l. So this can be written as minus m n square divided by, this must be l cube. Here is l square and this is l. So this must be equal to l cube. So just try to correct here. So this is typing mistake. So this must be x cube. So this must be just I am writing, this will be equal to, so there's a difficult to write here with. Okay, part 2. 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square, just we have to evaluate the value of this given equation as Lx square plus Mx plus n is equal to 0. Here is A is L. A is L and B is equal to M and C is equal to N. As alpha beta are the roots of the given equation, so sum of the root is B by A. So sum of the root is minus B by A, and product of the root is C by A. So value of B is M and A is L. So sum of the root is minus M by L, N by M by L. Sorry, and product of the root is C by A, and C is N and A is L. So 1 over alpha square plus 1 over beta square, when we take alpha square beta square as a common, so this alpha square cancel out with this one, so we have to write here beta, and then this beta square cancel out with this one, so we left with alpha square. So if you want to add here one extra step, so we write here this is alpha square, and it's a little bit difficult to write with that, so beta square. So when this cancel out with this one, so we have beta square. So when we multiply beta square with 1, we have beta square plus. Now this beta square cancel out with this one, we left with alpha square. Alpha square, when alpha square multiplied with 1, we left with alpha square. So you can add here, just after that you have to shift here, and then you have to, So alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha square plus beta square, and we know that alpha square plus beta square, as we have done in part question number one, that can be written as alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. Or and alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha beta whole square. You know, just replacing the values of some of the root and product of the root. So here alpha plus beta minus m by l whole square minus 2 alpha beta is n by l, and here alpha beta n by l whole square. So this can be written as so here is negative, and we have this this exponent or power is even, so this will be positive. M square by l square minus 2 n by l, here is this can be written as n by l. So we can take LCM. So this LCM will be equal to L square. So this L square cancel out with this one. So we have M square, and now here is L, here is L square. When this L, one L cancel out with this one and one L left. So when we multiply 2N with L, we have 2N L. Now N by L square can be written as L square by N square. So this is in division. When we convert this division into multiplication, so just we have to change the numerator and denominator values. So this L square cancel out with this one, and we have M square minus 2N L divided by L square. So this is exercise 2.4. So inshallah, in next lecture we will solve exercise 2.5.